What's going on, Neon Nation? Welcome back for a special type of Cyberpunk 2077 video. I've been wanting to make this one for quite a while now, and although it is going to be a little bit different, I think you guys are going to really enjoy this one. Today we're talking about just how realistic Cyberpunk 2077 actually is, and some reasons why our world is heading towards many of the things that Cyberpunk 2077 showcases. Cyberpunk 2077 is a good example to compare our real-world standards to because it's the amalgamation of almost everything from the cyberpunk genre. Everything from Braindance to its real-world comparison to talking about a lesser-known project Elon Musk is working on and its 2077 comparison to Orbital Air being a possibility for us to real-world cybernetics to modern-day cyberpsychosis as well as real-life megacorporations from the past and the future will be discussed in this video. Now obviously 2077 is a video game, but you might be surprised at just how many parallels you can draw from Cyberpunk 2077 to our modern world. First, let's look into cyberware. In 2077, augmenting the human body with cyberware is as fashionable as it is practical. In fact, augmenting the human body is pretty common and natural in the universe that Cyberpunk 2077 lies in. Everything from a biomonitor to maintain your vitals, to grafted on protective skins, to even weapons are all within the realm of possibility if you have the balls to visit a Ripper doc and let him cut away at your flesh and bone to replace it with cybernetics. Now prosthetics are popular in 2077, but people mostly get them out of choice. In our world, it's largely due to the need for amputees to get some normalcy back in their lives, and prosthesis main functions are replacing missing hands and limbs, which make everyday life easier. However, we are moving towards a more 2077-like way of handling prosthetics. First, prosthetics are getting denser, more resilient, and they can do a variety of different things that a regular human arm cannot. Deus Ex, a popular cyberpunk game, has partnered with Open Bionics in the past to make a 3D printed arm for amputees. Not only this, but MIT professor Hugh Herr, who lost his legs in an accident, has also created real-life augmentations to not only replace functioning legs, but to make them much more useful and powerful than our biological ones. Real skin, a tough leg covering for your shiny new cyber limbs, or subdermal armor in 2077 is also starting to become a thing today. I actually wrote an article about how something called viper skin is being developed to go over prosthetics to create a more natural looking limb, which can also sense heat changes through its membrane. This is because the heat sensing organs of pit viper snakes are used like a film within the artificial skin. Now in the world of Cyberpunk 2077, most pieces of tech can be controlled using a brain-computer interface called a neural processor. A neural router is planted in the bottom of the spine to route signals to different types of cyberware, as well as smart links to weapons and vehicles. In our modern day, the man, the myth, the legend, Elon Musk, is developing a real-life brain-computer interface called Neuralink. This piece of tech, also known as a neural mesh, sits within the brain and allows us to interact with all of our devices wirelessly with our minds. With everything requiring a Wi-Fi signal or having electronic components to it these days, this means the possibilities are limitless. Even the USB jack-styled cybernetic that we use in the demo is relevant in our real world. A brain can actually be tapped into and read of its intentions using nothing more than a futuristic probe. You can hack a human's mind and know exactly what they're thinking in real time as it happens. Brainiacs, a booster gang in the world of Night City, pride themselves on using skill chips and downloading a variety of skills on the fly. This is a reality in the making, with the potential to implant yourself with a brain chip and approach 200 IQ levels. Let's also not forget Braindance. Braindance is the sensory drug of the future and what we've referred to as VR on steroids in Cyberpunk 2077. People forego their real lives to go on Braindance binges where they're invested into a world and sensory experience so much better than their own that they allow their bodies to decay in the process. With people literally going on Netflix binges and VR becoming a growing industry, Netflix has caught on to the craze and will be implementing VR in the future. People staying up till 5 a.m. binging all 5 seasons of Breaking Bad is not uncommon even in today's world. You find a way to involve all the human senses into Netflix and mix VR into the equation, and you essentially have the same tools and escapist sentiment as what Braindance offers. In fact, by 2038, according to some sources, hyper-VR and AR will take over much of life. That's not even that far into the future. Next, let's take a look into cyberpsychosis. Cyberpsychosis is a mental affliction in 2077 where if you augment yourself with too many cybernetics, you start to dissociate from your mind and find yourself feeling more machine than human. In the world of cyberpunk, this makes you prone to mental instability, and at the very verge of it, you feel like destroying humans. This does sound a little bit too Terminator. In our reality, we face a different type of cyberpsychosis: social media and internet addiction. The amount of mental stress associated with constant social media comparisons, especially amongst kids, is at an absurdly high level. People are actually getting mental illnesses, such as depression and anxiety, based on how much time they spend online, these constant comparisons, the wealth of knowledge at your fingertips, the validation of likes and comments on social media, and more. Some reports suggest 38% of the general population is addicted to the web. The average time spent on the internet has gone up by leaps and bounds, and kids who are still developing are at a higher risk for social, functional, and emotional impairment. This is our modern-day cyberpsychosis. In Cyberpunk 2077, combat drugs are largely used by military puppets and veteran solos as a means to becoming a superhuman or soldier. It is said we use less than 10% of our brains, and combat drugs in both Cyberpunk 2077 and the real world unlock more of our potential performance. I'm not talking about steroids, I'm talking about experimental programs and chemical compositions which allow us to perform at a higher level. Militaries largely use psychoactive drugs with their soldiers to allow them to suppress hunger, sustain effort without food, suppression of fear, reduction of empathy, improve their reflexes, and even more. Reflex boosters and combat drugs in Cyberpunk 2077 allow the body to feel like time has slowed, and some modern-day military drugs have the same effect, especially ones with adrenal responses. Finally, we have Cyberpunk 2077's megacorporations, comparisons to how corporations do business today and the average human in the future. Cyberpunk 2077 features a diverse array of different ethnicities. Watson, which is a district we visit in the gameplay demo, is an example of this. We see Masala Studios and Kabayan Foods, vendors frying up pad thai, and women wearing headscarves. According to National Geographic, this is what the average female will look like in 2050. Cyberpunk's diversity in its population reflects this. The likes of Militech and Arasaka have become such big corporations in the world of 2077 that they supersede governments and nations. With both being valued at more than 400 billion euro dollars, it's hard to argue against their vice-like grip over Night City. We've had megacorporations in our real-world history as well. Check out this Reddit thread by TongueT88. In our history, we've had megacorporations like the Hanseatic League and the East India Company, who have dominated for hundreds of years in the case of Hanseatic League and made trillions in the case of the East India Company. We also have social media corporations who are growing exponentially. They have an unreal amount of data about everyone who uses the internet and has typed into search. They know your browsing habits, what you like, what you don't like, and whether you like it or not, sometimes know you better than you know yourself. Have you ever been on Facebook or Twitter and have seen an ad for a product you've literally never typed into search but have actively thought about? That's how accurate these social media algorithms actually are. SpaceX can also be actively compared to Orbital Air. I think we will see passenger transport into space or low orbit sooner than we think, which is the basis for both of these companies. We also have an oligopolistic system. I'll leave you with this graphic to explain this. There's no secret that big corporations today utilize smoke and mirror tactics to downplay their power in the world. They may not be the law like in Cyberpunk 2077, but our modern day megacorporations absolutely influence it. Thanks for watching, guys, and I hope you guys enjoyed a little change of pace here. for everything and anything Cyberpunk 2077, make sure you join Neon Nation by subscribing.